back to my channel, or welcome if it's your first time here. Today we're here for another one of my makeup collection videos, and in today's video we're going to talk about classic lipsticks. As usual, if you like this kind of videos, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also click the bell notification down below. This way you'll be notified every single time that I upload a new video. And if you want, you can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. But now let's start talking about the products. So today we're gonna take care of this part of my makeup collection, which is obviously my lipsticks and my like crayon lipsticks. So here they are. As you can see, I have many brands, and of course right in front of them I have all of my MAC lipsticks, which I'm very proud of. Just one more thing, since I won't be decluttering any of my MAC lipsticks, just because, as you know, they're very special to me and I chose every single one of this color with my heart, I don't want to show them to you today, just because I want to make later on a video about all of my MAC lipsticks, so to swatch them and to tell you what I think about them. So you won't be able to see this lipstick right here today, maybe just a glimpse to let you know what shades I own. I'll just be decluttering and swatching all the other ones. Here are the two nudes that I have by MAC. This is the color Mare and this is in the color Faux. Of course, we're missing Brave just because it's always in my purse, because it's my perfect go-to nude for every day. These are the two reds that I own. In here you have MAC's Red and in here you have Relentlessly Red. This name is such a difficult one to say for me. This one is a satin finish and this one is a retro matte. I couldn't stop wearing this one last summer. And this is the first MAC lipstick that I ever purchased. Well, it was a gift from my boyfriend, so it doesn't count as if I bought it. It's this deep purpley burgundy that I just love. On the lips it stays a little bit more light than it seems in the packaging. I love it so much. I just couldn't wait to have it in my collection. So make sure to subscribe, this way you won't miss my MAC lipstick collection. Also because, as you know, for Christmas I received some more lipsticks, so it's gonna be a good one. Let's move to the second row. This one is a mini lipstick by Marc Jacobs and it's in the color 110 Roleplay, and it was part of the new nudes collection. I got it in this mini size just because it was in a discovering set. I have to say that I imagine it to be a little bit bigger. It's really really small. Unfortunately, it's really a purse lipstick. I don't have anything against the color of it, it just gives a little bit of a taint to your lips, so I really think that I'm gonna declutter it to make room for something that I love more. Moving on, we have a Kiko Unlimited Stilo and this one was in the color 17. I kind of like the packaging with the like the closure like this. I don't like the fact that it's like a bullet that is rounded on the two sides, but whatever, it's just the packaging. As you can see, it's still like intact. Haven't touched it, not even once, and I don't know why it is, so we're just gonna swatch it to understand. It's very very creamy and honestly the color is beautiful. I guess that I just don't touch it because I have very similar shades between my MAC lipsticks. So this one is gonna stay in my collection, this way I'm gonna try it out. Then as you can see I have four of the same Kiko lipsticks, so we're gonna see them all. So again, I'm not that much of a fan of the packaging, but one thing that I actually really really like is the fact that it has a magnetic closure, so this way you feel more safe. These lipsticks are the Velvet Passion Matte Lipsticks and this one is in the color 313. Okay, so this one I definitely touched it and used it more than once. I really love this color. This is the color that looks best on my skin tone. It's just this deep pinkish reddish color and it's gonna stay in my collection. The second one that I have here for you is the number 310, which is this bright corally red, which reminds me a lot of Relentlessly Red. Yeah, definitely not as neon as the MAC one, but still a good dupe if you're just looking for something that's similar in color. So that one is gonna stay as well. This one is in the color 315 and I remember that there was a time where this was everything that was on my lips, like all of the time. So once I swatch it right now, I can say that it's a little bit too cold toned for my skin tone, but I really don't care. I really like this color and I think that it looks good with a grayish, silverish looks because it stays in the cold tone atmosphere. But I also think that if you pair this with a very orangey look, it's just gonna make your eyes pop even more. So for all time's sake, this is gonna stay. Next one, we have the color 303 and I can tell that it's almost never been touched. Maybe it has just been swatched and I guess that this one is one that is not gonna stay, but we're gonna swatch it anyway. I don't have anything against this color. I think it's beautiful. I just think that it's a little bit too orangey for my skin tone. So I guess that I'm never gonna grab it. So I just think that it's gonna stay on the side for the moment. Next we have
3 Megala Sleep Color by Wet n Wild, and oh my gosh, it was such a nightmare to find these colors just because in Italy we weren't able to find them anywhere. Just one thing, can you see how messy the packaging is? It's one thing that I'll never stand about these lipsticks. We have a nude in the color Movera here. I mean, half of the lipstick is like on the cap, and I can feel it dancing inside the packaging. I have to say that I do remember why I love this, just because they go on so extremely pigmented and like creamy. Then we have a corally red in the color Cherry Picking. This one has a different effect once you swatch it, just because it feels like glue, it feels like it's stuck to your skin. I love the color though. Then we have the very famous Sugar Plum Fairy, which is a burgundy shade. This one, I still remember that I chose it just because it was meant to be a dupe for Brave by MAC. Oh my god, I hate to have to admit this, but guys, this one swatches better than Brave by MAC. Like, it's unbelievable how less patchy it is. So I guess that I'm just gonna have to take back everything that I said. I'm just gonna keep them despite the packaging that I hate. This one is a Rimmel London lipstick, which was part of the Kate Moss collection, as you can see, because it has the red Kate signature in here. This was one of the lasting finish by Kate, and the color, I guess, is the number 9 or the number 60. This was a gift from my mom, and this was one of my first dark red lipsticks, which I was like wearing non-stop all the time. And this one is never gonna leave my collection. We still have 4 Kiko lipsticks to swatch. This is a lip sealer in the color number 10. To be honest, I fell in love with the packaging of this one as well as with the color. As you can see, it's this beautiful rose gold but also like indented packaging, and it's just amazing. It was part of a collection where all of the packaging was like this. So as usual, it's a deep burgundy reddish color. I can clearly remember that the problem with this was just the fact that it was so patchy and it like moved everywhere. So I really wanted to keep this in my collection just because of the packaging, but I really don't know what to do with it, just because I know that I won't be able to wear it like never again, just because I already know that it's gonna end up all over my face. I guess that I'm gonna have to declutter it. Then we have an Intensely Lavish lipstick in the color number 5, and I like the color of this one better than the other one just because it's a little bit more coppery and pinkish. This one seems okay in pigmentation and creaminess. I kind of remember that I had the same problem with this one where it just got all over my face, but I really want to try it again to see if it can work so it's gonna stay. And then we have 2 other Kiko lipsticks. These were the Unlimited Stilo, but in the old, very old packaging. The first one is a nude that I used to wear all the time, is the color 13. This one has a perfect application in just one swipe. You have full pigmentation, full color, it's very creamy, plus I can remember that it stays on the lips perfectly all day long without even using a lip pencil, so this one has to stay. Then we have a very dark color, the number 12, and you can imagine why I love this color, just because it's not patchy at all. Even though it's a burgundy shade, this one glides on your lips, you can't even feel it on. I remember that this was the color that I used to wear every time that I got out in the evening, just because I knew that I wanted something that was gonna last with drinks and like with eating stuff. And finally we get to my crayon lipsticks. So the first one, of course, is by Kiko. This was in the color number 105, and this was a creamy pencil for your cheeks and your lips. It's a dark pinkish nude. I really think that I'm gonna keep it in my collection, plus I'm also gonna try it as a blush just because I've never did it before. I just forgot that it was meant to be used for both of them. Then the other 3 pencils that I have are from NARS. These are the Velvet Matte Lip Pencils, and oh my gosh, I've been dreaming of this shade since I was like 12 years old, and I actually bought these 2 shades in a mini set together just to see if I like the quality of them before buying the full size of that one. And when you apply these products, it really feels like you're applying some velvet on your skin. It's amazing. If you can, go to a Sephora and try them on, because the quality is just gonna leave you with like no words. This is the color Dolce Vita, and I have to say that I really hoped for it to be a little bit more on the pinky side. Well, it's actually more on the orangey side, so unfortunately I'll have to declutter it, not because I don't like the quality of it, just because the color is not a color that I reach for like on an everyday basis. This one is in the color Cruella, and of course I love this name. It's a little bit more of a terracotta red, and I really think that I'm gonna keep it in my collection just because I don't have another color that looks like this one. And then we have the one that I love the most, because this one is in the color Dragon Girl. The name already says it all. is just stunning. Again, it's this sort of corally red pinkish shade, which I just love. I didn't even have to swatch it to know that I really want to keep this in my collection.
So I really hope you liked this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel or follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. As usual, thank you guys so much for watching, and I guess I'll see you next time. Bye bye!